Hello, YouTube. It is Championdjk bringing you yet again another full series, complete series Auto World video. If you're not familiar with this, every time I complete an Auto World series, I try to get a video out showing all of the cars, the version A, the version Bs, and then, of course, the Ultra Red Chase cars. And every once in a while, we get to look at an Ultra Raw. I don't have a Raw for this set. This was the last Ultra Red that I needed to complete it. So, acquired that a little while ago. I already showed it on the Diecast Weekly episodes. But, of course, now we got to open it and complete our last car that we need for Auto World 2021 Release 4. So you can tell how kind of patient I am because I don't complete these sets super fast usually. So this is 2021 Release 4. So kind of released at the tail end of 20. Actually, I think it might have been released in the beginning of 2022, actually. I'm trying to think of when these actually came out because everything got delayed and all that stuff. These were manufactured in July of 2021, but they definitely didn't come out, I don't think, anywhere close to that. So, without further ado, let's get into it. This is actually the number one car in the set, but of course we're going to open it last. I'm going to set it kind of back here in the background for now, so we're just going to kind of look at it back there. We'll look at the other Lincoln Continental. It was the debut of this casting was in this set. So that was one of the really exciting things about this set when it came out. So let's skip the car two, or vehicle number two in the set for a minute here. And this is the square body Chevy. So we've got this 1984 Chevrolet Silverado. And take some close looks at it here. This is the version A in light and dark blue poly. So it's got a metal flake to it. Take a look at the plate. It says 1984 on the plate. And this was limited to 18,798 pieces. And so Auto World really doesn't put production numbers on these things anymore. My guess is because they're probably plus 20,000 now. And this one was 18,798, which was the most produced model in this set. Very nice looking square body. So that's the version A. And then the version B we get right here in a red, orange, and black. And it is kind of a orangish red, I guess. It looks pretty good. I definitely prefer the blue on blue version of it. I think that looks a little bit better. Looks like the plate is the same, 1984 for the plate. Very nice. Of course, the hood opens on these models, as well as the tailgate flips down. But I'm not going to pop the tailgate down because it's nice and tight and stuck up there. And I don't really want to, you know, whatever. You maneuver that a lot, it can get a little bit loose. They're easy to fix, kind of, but it can happen. Little Silverado logo right there. Looking really good. I really like this blue one. I think the blue one is really nice. But then we got the Ultra Red. So this is the first Ultra Red we can look at here for the series. And this is where we're going to gather what the traits are. So kind of an interesting set because the Ultra Reds here have kind of your standard fare for Ultra Red traits. But one of the things that you don't get to see too often is the Ultra Reds actually use the traits from the version B vehicle. So this is the version B, and it's got the black stripe on the side, whereas the version A has the blue. So this one in particular has the black because they use the version B car and make the Ultra Red version. So it doesn't matter, of course, what card you find it on, whether or not it is the version A or version B card. Does not matter. You will find it in version B traits. Okay. And then, of course, it's got Ultra Red body, okay, which is a standard trait for Ultra Red chase cars, typically. You've got a white base, which you've seen before, red tires, which you've seen before, white rims. So we got the white base and the white rims, red tires, red body, and one more, ultra red interior. pretty nifty. Lots of traits on this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is there anything under the hood that's special? No. Sometimes they will put a white motor in there. They do that every now and then. So this being roughly 3% of the production line, we're guessing that this is limited to about 1,128 pieces. Okay? Which is funny that it's limited to over 1,000 pieces, because there have been some Auto World regular releases from like 2017 and whatnot, and that have been limited to that amount for just the regular releases, not the chase vehicle. So pretty cool there. All right, so that's number one. Number two, we get this guy right here. This is the 2019 Chevrolet Camaro ZL1. These, both version A and version B, were limited to 15,390 pieces. And you might be asking, why are these less made than the Silverados? Well, that's because these are also available in what they call straight packs to hobby dealers. So you didn't just have to get this in a six-car set as a hobby dealer. You could actually order straight packs of one particular release or one particular car. And that's why. They just made less of these than they did the Silverado, thinking that the Silverado would likely be more popular. And that makes sense, right? To me, it makes sense. I mean, the Camaro's cool, but the Silverado is definitely more popular. All right, so we got this one in black. Okay. Looks pretty good. It is 650 horsepower with a California plate. Looks pretty good. We'll open the hood on the white one. Then we have it in Summit White. Very good looking color for this car. Actually, the black one looks really good too. Let's go ahead and get that hood open. Look at the engine detail. Probably just a little bit easier to see it on the white one. And that looks pretty decent. Snap shut nice and easy. 650 horsepower. So yeah, pretty decent looking little Camaro. And then we've got the Ultra Red. And then, of course, this is going to go on the version B. So we got the white base. We got the white rims, the red tires, the Ultra Red interior, and, of course, the Ultra Red body. But then we got the matte black hood, which is what we have on the version B car. The version A has a gloss black hood. It's all just gloss black all over. So there's that. All right, so that is car number three in the set. Car number four is the 1993 Dodge Stealth. Very cool casting from Auto World. I was super excited when they first released this casting. It's very, very nice in this dark silver, is this color. Sneaky Pennsylvania plate. Looking pretty good. Let's go ahead and pop the hood on this one. Check out the engine detail, which looks pretty decent. Hood shuts nice. Very neat in the silver, the dark silver. And then we got this weird color. This is peacock green. And I don't know how well this translates over video. In person, it's one of those colors. It's just slightly difficult to describe, I guess, other than saying that it's peacock green, which I guess, it does kind of remind me of a peacock's feathers. But it's a strange color. It's weird. It's not green, really. It's not blue, really. It's not like a traditional blue, teal, green, you know, tealish color either. Under different lighting conditions, it looks slightly different. So it's just an odd color. It's a weird color. It's one of those colors that's kind of difficult for me to, like, describe, I guess. Which is neat. That's what's neat about having the factory colors on these cars, is just, you know, you're going to get some weird ones that they put out for these cars. And I don't know. I don't know if I've ever seen a stealthy peacock green. But, or if it's really the best color for this car. It's not bad. But, you know, red is kind of the color for this car, really. But that's color kind of for all Dodges of this era. But we do get it in red anyway. We get it in ultra red. And again, this is going to go up to the version B traits. However, it doesn't really make a difference for this particular model because nothing is different except for the actual color of the car between the version A and version B. I don't see any other difference there. So it's just you either get it in silver or you get it in peacock green. All the other trim and stuff like that, it's all the same color on both. So technically, there's no real way to tell the difference between whether it would be version A or version B for the Ultra Red because it's just got the same traits of the other two cars. So, bad example, but you do get, you know, the Ultra Red body, interior, tires, white rims, white base for the Dodge Stealth. Pretty cool. Pretty cool looking car. Not bad. I actually kind of like the white rims. I'm not super into the colored tires for a chase, but I get it. It makes it look obviously like a chase. And definitely, I will say, the chases from Auto World that have the different colors for tires, whether they're white or red, typically go for more money on eBay than Ultra Reds that just have the black tires. And I think that's just because they're so obviously a chase that there's no questioning it for people that, you know, aren't really diehard Auto World collectors. Maybe they don't, they want a chase to look like a chase, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So since it's so obviously a chase, they tend to go for a little bit more money. The other ones with just the black tires and stuff are my favorite just because it looks like kind of another color variation of the car. But they got to mix it up a bit. They have to. Otherwise, you know, you'd have the same looking Ultra Reds over and over and over again. All right. Now, this next one actually kind of, you know, not the version A, but the version B we're about to look at might be my favorite vehicle in the series. This is the 1963 Chevy II Nova Station Wagon. They made these to the tune of 15,126 pieces. I guess we really kind of forgot to talk about Ultra Red Limited stuff for a minute. So like this one, we figure is approximately 868 pieces. The Camaro, 924. We already talked about the Silverado being over 1,000. So this one is... So 1,126 pieces. This is an ermine white. And it's a pretty cool, nice looking classic. It looks very premium style car. This kind of reminds me of Tomica Limited Vintage a little bit. It's plain. It's a plain classic vehicle. So pretty neat there. We can open the hood. These all have opening hoods. Pretty nifty there. Pretty cool, pretty cool. So pop quiz for you. What's the only Auto World premium casting that does not have an opening hood? There is only one. Right? Well, okay, so we should say opening engine cover. It's the Ford GT40. So, ermine white, it looks good. It looks classic. It looks good. But version B, look at this. You change the wheels on something. This is in silver blue poly, but you change the wheels on this machine, and wow, does it look a lot tougher. That looks awesome. The wheels do not roll all that well on this one. I do not care, though, because they put these thick tires on it. They just gave it a way, way, way better look. It just looks a lot, you know, better. So, and of course, then the Ultra Red is going to be, you know, version B traits. So we're going to get these rims on the Ultra Red, which is cool. So 1963 on the plate there. Actually roll better on the Ultra Red. But here's the Ultra Red. So white version of the rims. Red tires, of course, white base, Ultra Red body, Ultra Red interior, and this is a pretty cool looking one. Very, very cool. But yeah, this might be my favorite, actually. This version B, Chevy 2, I think is actually my favorite in this set. Even though the Lincoln Continental, it was the first release of that casting, this thing just, I don't know, something, it's just complete. I really like it in this set. I think it's my favorite. I'd like to know what your favorite is by the end of the video. That's fun. Always fun to hear which one you thought was the best, which one wins for you. And then we got this guy. So this is of course, the Chevy Corvette, C8 Corvette 2020. 15,702 pieces. This first one's in torch red. This, I believe, was the second set of cars for this tooling. I think the first time we saw it was in 2021 release 2. It came out in white, and one was white, one was black. And then they skipped the release, and then we got this one in release 4. So looks pretty good in this red with the black stripes. This is a nice tooling, and the reason why I stopped myself before with the opening hood thing is because this, I guess, doesn't technically have an opening hood, right? Pretty nifty. You can see the motor in there. Shuts pretty good. Auto World did a great job with this tooling. I think it does look really nice. And we get it in, of course, two colors. You get the version A. And then the version B is in accelerate yellow. And I definitely prefer it in this yellow color over the red. The yellow with the black rims. It just looks really nice. Nice and mean. Very, very sporty looking. Very cool. It kind of is a good like contrast too with having the red like engine detail with the yellow body color. And like it's got red seats as well in both of them. So even the yellow one has red seats. So just a little bit more going on with this one, and I do quite like it. C8 LT2 Utah plates. That's neat. So, and then we got the Ultra Red. So the Ultra Red again, I guess it would be easy to say if it didn't have white painted rims, you'd be able to obviously tell that it is the version B version, but it really doesn't matter on this one because there is no difference other than the rims, other than being silver to black. But of course now they're white for the chase vehicle. You still got that ultra red interior. You've got the white rims, of course, red tires and the white base. Limited to approximately 942 pieces. So the most limited ultra red in this release is actually the Stealth. And then this one would be second at 908 pieces. And then you got this one. The 924, the ZL1 Camaro. And then this one. Whatever. So 942 pieces approximately on this Corvette. Pretty cool. And I love that. Just thump of dropping one of these on the ground. They are dropping one of these on the desk. They are. They got a good weight to them. All these cars, if you're not super familiar with Auto World, and this is like your first time watching something about Auto World, whatever. They're all metal and they're heavy. They're very well done and they're very cool. But it's time for to put a close to this set and deal with our Lincoln Continental Mark V. So, debut of this casting, was super excited to see it. Still just think it's a great idea that they did this one. 1977 Lincoln Continental Coupe Mark V, limited to 16,206 pieces. This first one in medium blue diamond bright. And can we get a hood to open? Well, we'll try the black one. We will get one to open. I'm going to have to get one to open. This thing is massively long. I think it is the longest Auto World casting for sure. I think it's even longer than some of the trucks. Maybe the Chevy, the newer Silverado Chevy truck. That might be longer than this one. But it's longer than the Cadillacs that they've put out and stuff like that. It is just a very lengthy car. Yeah, what plate do we got? 1977 Alabama. I'm trying to hold that steady. Sorry about that. Blue interior. And then next we got version B. And a very appropriate color for this car. Just straight up black. And it looks real good. In black. black. I picked up a bunch of these, actually. As I saw them on the pegs, both the black one and the blue one. Can we get that hood open? Ah, it just doesn't want to. Let me see if I can get a tool in here and do it. I had, like, something handy. Well, we may have to just go for it on the Ultra Red. It's a tough one to get open. It does open. The nice thing is it shuts tight, and that's, you know, so we don't have any issues there. But let's go ahead and get the Ultra Red open. It's limited to 972 pieces, not extremely rare from, you know, chase pieces are concerned. And none of the Ultra Reds really are. Being at 3%, you know, unless you get those early ones that have the really low production, there's our Ultra Red open. So again, it would be version B traits, but it really doesn't make a difference because, again, the only differentiating factor really besides paint color, the main paint color for the two, version A and version B this time, is the interior. And, well, we got a Ultra Red interior in this one. So nothing to really look at there. There's a white base, white rims, red tires, Ultra Red body, Ultra Red interior, of course, as we mentioned. And can we get the freaking hood to open? And we're not gonna get it, are we? I feel like I have to open one, and it's just being really difficult. Hang on, I gotta take it off camera for a second. I'm gonna do something super risky. And you don't even want to know what I'm trying to do here. And that's not really doing good either. Oh, there we go. I went ahead and I took a razor blade and I put it in there and I opened it up. So risky. I have multiple copies of this car, so did it for the sake of the video, I suppose. But there you go. You get to see some engine detail in there. Nothing too crazy, but there you go. And once it shuts super tight. Very, very good and very nice. All right, so last Ultra Red of the set. So we are finally complete. I've got some more of these to do. If you want to see some more episodes just like this or any Auto World unboxing or just straight up Auto World content, of course, go to my playlists on the channel and go to the Auto World playlist and you will see other content such as this. Hopefully you guys enjoy these videos. They typically don't perform all that well, usually because, you know, this series has been out for a while, so there's nothing really new for anyone, you know, but I have to do this. It's just my part of documenting these series as I complete them. So got to do it. So hopefully you enjoy it, those of you that did watch. All right. Thank you guys very much again for watching. Have a great day.